Welcome back to my channel, baddies. This is what I'm gonna teach you guys how to make today. Oh my gosh, she is so beautiful. She has lots of different layers, lots of different elements. Oh my gosh, major Victorian vibes. I seriously regret selling this because it's so beautiful and I wanna keep it. But anyway, you guys, the inspiration for this Tumblr was Nicole Marett. If you don't know who she is, oh my gosh, she is phenomenal. Look her up on all social media outlets. She's also on YouTube. She does phenomenal tutorials. I saw her post a really beautiful Tumblr on her TikTok and I used it as inspiration for this. I added my own twist, my own little elements, and this is what I came up with. I'm super in love with it. This tutorial was so much fun to make and I cannot wait to hear your guys' feedback. I cannot wait to see what you guys think about it. I work really hard on the tutorials because you guys deserve the best. Let's get right into it, my love bugs. Okay, so I am starting off by prepping my tumbler. I'm using a 60 grit sanding block just to scuff it up, rough it up, beat it up a little. And that this helps so that my epoxy adheres better. I don't want anything to repel. It just helps have a longer lasting tumbler, in my opinion. Don't come for me. But anyway, guys, moving right along, I'm gonna use alcohol and a paper towel to wipe off any residue. Guys, oh my gosh, I cannot wait to start this tumbler. I'm so excited. Okay, I'm gonna link all of the materials that I used in the description. We're gonna start off with these natural sponges that I got at Walmart, Wally World, or as my people say, Hualmar. And then we are going to, I wanted to do a very light pink, so I decided to mix pink with white kind of to get a little bit of a lighter pink. And then I'm gonna use that textured sponge. So for this tumbler, I want lots of texture, lots of just really cool elements. So that's why I decided to use a textured. Guys, English is really hard sometimes, okay? English is my second language. Textured sponge. But anyway, so basically, I'm also going to be using some tattoos. Here they are. I got them on Amazon. Guys, I won't be able to provide a link for the tattoos because those are from last year. But there is an abundance of tattoos on Amazon, so you will find beautiful flowers. So what we're going to do is we're going to take our textured sponge, and we're just going to We're gonna dab our sponge all over the tumbler. Now, I don't necessarily wanna get full coverage over that stainless steel. Oh my gosh, when I see my hand moving in like fast motion, I just wanna go da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Guys, I'm sorry, be serious. This is serious stuff, okay? But anyway, I don't necessarily wanna get full coverage over that stainless steel just because I want it to look like there's different dimensions and different like textures and layers and all of that stuff. So I just kind of want to dab it until I feel like I have good coverage that I feel comfortable with. And this is totally up to you guys. And also something that you guys could do to like make this a little bit better. You could use two colors if you wanted to, like if you wanted to kind of throw in two colors. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to add another color in here. But here's what it looks like when it's dry, you guys. Okay, it looks very textured, very pimply, dimply, like my thighs. Okay, so sorry, that was inappropriate. Please don't unsubscribe. Anyhoodly, moving right along. So now I'm gonna take the same textured sponge and I am gonna do white. The reason I'm gonna do white is because I'm gonna apply a tattoo and I want it to show up really, really, really good. And also I feel like adding white is gonna add even more dimension and layers and texture. So I'm kind of doing the white in the same direction that the flower tattoo is gonna lay. But I also, once I don't have that much paint left on my sponge, I kind of just want to do random little areas to create those little specks of texture, just to kind of give that, to be honest, guys, I don't really know what I'm going for here at this point. I mean, now I know what I was going for because now I'm done. But at this moment in time, when I was filming, I didn't know where I was going with this tumbler. I was like, well, you guys know what?
Let's just go for it. Let's take a risk. Life is too short. YOLO, you only live once. Ooh, if my son heard me say YOLO, he'd be so embarrassed. Anyhoodly, so here's what it looks like once it's dry, you guys. I really like how the textured sponge makes it look like this is the exact look that I was like picturing in my head. So I'm actually going to do a tattoo on the backside too. So I just kind of want to create that white, space for the tattoo to lay over. And guys, this does not have to be perfect. And honestly, when you guys do this, if you guys want to do your own design, your own color scheme, your own technique, you don't even have to do tattoos. You can do water slides, whatever you want. You're the artist. And I feel like this is a style of Tumbler that is very... Do it as you go, because I swear I had no idea what the outcome of this was going to look. I just kind of knew what colors I wanted to use. I knew that I wanted to use these tattoos because they were so beautiful. But I did not know how it was all going to come together, which I can't wait for you guys to see the final product. Anyway, you guys, so right now I'm just kind of tapping. All the way around, just want to give it some texture, make it look real nice. And then once I felt like I had enough white area for my tattoo, that is when I was like, okay, I can stop now. So just so you guys know, I waited for each layer of paint to dry before I moved on to my next step. Okay, well, I'm a liar. Apparently, I wasn't done. So now we're just tapping, adding a little bit more texture. Something that I thought was going to look super cool was lace. So I ordered a lace stencil from Amazon and I decided to just test it out to add even more layers. And I just thought it would give like a really cool, like girly romantic effect. Now, like I said, you guys, the entire time I was doing this Tumblr, I was kind of going with a flow, had no freaking idea if this was going to work. So one tip that I can give you right off the bat that I eventually learned as I was doing this was when you're going to use your sponge to do it over the stencil, make sure you use a smooth one. You don't want one with texture. So you want one like the one I'm using here. And you want to do very thin coats of paint. So if you see at the top, kind of towards the top left of the tumbler, there's like this white blob of paint, that, which is fine. I just kind of, you know, dabbed it with a textured sponge just to kind of spread it out a little bit. But basically that wouldn't have happened if I would have dabbed a little bit off the paint off of the sponge before I started applying it over the stencil. So to avoid that kind of thing, just make sure you don't have your, just make sure your sponge is not soaked in paint. I learned that the hard way. It took me a couple of times to realize that that's why that was happening. But anyway, you guys, they have tons of really cool stencils on Amazon. I'm going to link this one, but you guys, the possibilities are endless. I know if you go to Michael's and Hobby Lobby and all of those craft stores, they typically carry these stencils in person. So you can go look at all the options, see everything that they have. You don't even have to do this part if you don't want to, but I thought that it added a really cool element. Whoa, come back. See, so there's, another little section that it happened to, but it didn't bother me too much, because I used my, textured sponge to kind of blend it out a little bit. And also, I like all the different elements, so it was fine. Guys, now after that completely dries, we're going to move on to our tattoo placement. Ugh, I freaking love tattoos. So I'm just cutting off the excess, space around the tattoo. You don't have to do that. I just have always gotten myself into the habit of doing that for some reason. But just remember that whenever you're going to place your tattoo, it is not like a water slide. Once you peel off that protective cover that I just peeled off and you place it on your tumbler, you can't adjust it and move it around. Wherever you place it, that's where it's going to stay. So once I found a little spot that I felt I liked, I made sure that I held the tattoo in place very securely with my other hand. And then I took a paper towel. I got it damp, wet, moist, soaked. I soaked it. And then I was just pressing down. You want to make sure that you have enough water because the more water you use, the easier the tattoo will come off. And you want to also make sure that you apply pressure. Both of those things are going to be the key to helping you get the tattoo on. Ooh, here's the satisfying part. Look at that. Ooh, she's a beaut. Oh, my Lanta. Get the heck out of town. Pack your bags and go. Oh, guys, watching this footage over again. So freaking obsessed. I wish I could keep this cup. Dude, I seriously want to keep every single tumbler I make. I've got to get rid of that mentality, you guys. But anyway, I'm freaking obsessed with how the tattoo looks. So once it dried all the way, I went ahead and applied the tattoo to the backside. The reason I place a paper towel underneath the cup is because some of the water from applying the second tattoo is going to go down to the other side. And I don't want the tumbler slipping and sliding on the pool noodle and potentially damaging the tattoo. So that's why I did a paper towel. Now we're going to apply the same process to the second tattoo that we're applying. You want to get it nice and damp. You want to make sure you're putting enough pressure, pushing down on it. And here comes the satisfying part. So for this one, I ended up not being able to peel it off for some reason. I was having an issue. So I ended up just slowly sliding it off like this. Ooh, slippity sliding all the way. You slippity slippity sliding. How satisfying was that, you guys? So stinking cool. So if you have an issue pulling up your tattoo, if you feel like it's peeling up the image, just slippity slide it off really slowly. And then once I'm done, I just take a paper towel and I very gently tap the excess water off. And now I'm going to set this aside and I'm going to let it fully dry before I come back to do the next steps. I'm out of breath, you guys. Anyway, I hope that you guys are following and I hope you guys are loving it as much as I love it. Okay, I'm back. Hee hee, I never left. Okay, guys, so I don't know what these sheets are called, but I'm gonna link them in the description. They're like these foil sheets, and I applied them with tack it, and it's gonna add a really cool element to the cup. Because remember, we're looking for layers, texture, and just lots of really cool elements. So I'm gonna use tack it. You can get it on Amazon, Michaels, wherever you want. And I'm using an eyeshadow brush because you guys know how much I love eyeshadow brushes. So basically, I'm just applying a little bit of tack it wherever I think that I want the foil. Guys, it's really hard to explain to you like where I wanted it because I had no idea. As a matter of fact, when I was putting down the first little bit of tack it, I was like, oh my gosh, I hope I like how this looks because it's too late. I'm going to put it down. So I just kind of went with the flow as I was doing it. And so basically you just rip little pieces of the foil off and you kind of just put them with your finger wherever you applied the glue and just press it down. It gives it this really cool, like vintagey, fancy, bougie, classy, sassy, moody. I'm just kidding. I need to get off TikTok. I watch too many TikToks. But anyway, it just gives it this like really cool, like classic look. And so I fell in love with it. And I was basically using a dry brush just to remove off any excess flakes because I wanted to look freaking cool in front of my YouTube family. I don't even know if you have to do that. I just thought it would be cool to like bring out a brush and make it look like I knew what I was doing. But the whole time I was holding my breath, like, please don't mess this up. Please don't mess this. Dear Lord, if you help me get this cup good, I will stop overeating because I know gluttony is a sin. Hee hee. Amen. But anyway, guys, so, I basically just did this all around and I wanted to use this like copper color and the gold color, just because I thought that they both kind of really went good with my color scheme. And I'm going to, dare I say it again, I was looking for layers and texture. So I just kind of did a little cocktail of everything. Ooh, I know the perfect example. Okay, you know when you make yourself nachos at home and like you just throw a whole bunch of shit on the plate and you're not trying to make it look pretty or anything, but you know that no matter what, the nachos are going to be freaking bomb. That's what this cup is. This is like a plate of nachos. You want to put as much stuff as you can on it and pray to God that they're not going to get soggy. Well, okay, I guess that doesn't really apply. Okay, that's a bad example. Anyway, guys, I'm going to speed it up a little bit because this is a long process, but I basically just went around the tumbler and picked all the little random spots that I thought were going to look good with foil, and I did it. Please enjoy this music.
Kiss me hard before you go. Summertime sadness. I just wanted you to know. Maybe you're the best. I got my red dress on tonight. Dancing in the dark in the pale moonlight. Got my hair up real big, beauty queen style. High heels off. Scares me anymore. Kiss me hard before you go. Summertime sadness. I just wanted you to know that baby, you're the best. Ooh. Got the summertime, summertime sadness. This is summertime, summertime sadness.
Hope you guys enjoyed that amazing cover of Summertime Sadness. It's one of my freaking favorites. Okay, guys, so what I'm doing here is I'm using Mod Podge to sprinkle a little bit of opal glitter in different little random sections. I wasn't really sure where I was going with this. I just knew that I wanted to add a little bit of texture, even more, a little bit of color. So I was just kind of looking for little random spots to add glitter to. If I'm being completely honest, I ended up actually not loving the way that the opal glitter looked. I think it's because the tumbler had lots of like pinks and golds and copper colors. And then the opal was picking up this like purple, bluish tint. And I just wasn't in love with how it looked. But it's okay because this was a trial and error. Like, you can kind of go, like, add as you go. You can mess with it as much as you want. And so I'm going to show you guys how I ended up fixing the whole opal glitter thing. The opal glitter could have been really beautiful if this was a different color scheme. Maybe if I would have done like a gold chunky glitter, I would have liked it more. But it's okay, you guys, because like I said, I'm actually going to show you how I corrected the parts that I didn't like, which I think is a perfect example just to show you guys that if you're working on a cup and you do something and you're like, oh yeah, I'm not in love with this, guys, nothing is permanent, especially in tumblers. You can either restart if you absolutely hate it, or there's lots of ways for you to fix your mistakes. Anyway, guys, keep watching. Like, after it's dry, I really like how it's coming along, but I know I'm gonna want to do more stuff to it. But for now, we're gonna seal it with polycrylic. I like to buy the clear gloss one, and I'm gonna spray all the areas with opal glitter and with the flakes on it, and then we'll be back for epoxy. Oh wow, we're already back. Look at that. Hee hee. Okay, guys, this is what it looks like after one coat of epoxy. I'm super duper enamored with it. In the next step, I'm going to show you how I fixed the opal glitter that I wasn't in love with. I'm going to show you guys how I covered that up. Oh my gosh, this looks so beautiful with the first coat of epoxy. Oh my goodness, I cannot. Okay, guys, so what I'm going to do now is I am going to apply some more leaf flakes, sheets. I realized that it didn't have enough, and I was really going for that like classic, like
I don't even want to say Bridgerton, but like, you know, just like super pretty, like classy, womany, lovely, fancy, bougie. Just, you know what I'm trying to say. Like, ooh, 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 I know the word. Almost like Victorian. Oh my gosh, look at me. My English is so good. Like Victorian look with all the gold and stuff on it. So I just decided that adding more of these gold and copper sheets would be my best option because sneaky, sneaky me, I can hide some of that opal glitter by adding some gold and copper sheet flakes over it. But anyway, you guys, that is the beauty of this style of tumbler, is that if you add something and even if you epoxy it and you're like, shoot, I don't love that, I wasn't in love with that, girlfriend, don't sweat it, okay? You can go ahead and add something over it, whatever you wanted. You could add lace to hide it up a little bit. You could dab some acrylic paint over it with a textured sponge. You could add these gold and copper sheets over it. Like, girl, there is no wrong with this tumbler. You can just mess with it until it is exactly how you want it. But I'm really excited that I was able to hide those areas with the gold sheets, just like I would hide my love handles with yoga pants. And stop me when I lie. But anyway, you guys, I'm going to speed up the process and I am going to let you guys watch me work because it's super tedious. And you guys don't want to sit here for 2 hours and just watch me do the same thing over and over. I've already explained it, so I feel pretty good about it. Also, I want to play a bomb song for you. I feel like a DJ. Now taking requests. Okay, I'm done. I'm done messing around.
It's getting late. I'm making my way over to my favorite place. I gotta get my body moving, shake the stress away. I wasn't looking for nobody when you look my way. Possible candidate, yeah. Who knew that you'd be up in here looking like you do? You're making staying over here impossible. Baby, I'ma say your art is incredible. If you don't have to go, no. Do you know what you started? I just came here to party. Now we're rocking on the dance floor, acting naughty. Hands around my waist, just let the music play. We're hand in hand, chest to chest, now we're face to face. Cause I wanna take you away, let's escape into the music. DJ, let it play, I just can't refuse it. Like the way you do this, keep on rocking to it. Please don't stop the play. Are you ready? Cause it's getting close. Don't you feel the passion ready to explode? What goes on between us, no one has to know. This is a private show. You know I just started. I just came here to party. Now we're rocking on the dance floor, acting naughty. Your hands around my waist, just let the music play.
sweet baddies. So I am just adding the finishing touches to my tumbler. I forgot to record the part where I apply epoxy to the last layer, so I'm so sorry. But after I finished applying all the foil, I sealed it with polycrylic spray again, like I showed you guys at the beginning. And then I went ahead and I applied my final coat of epoxy. I did a pretty generous coat so that I only had to do one. And I'll be right back with the finished product.
As always, thank you so much for watching. You guys are my favorite. And until next time, I love you guys. Besitos.